Good morning, students. Today, let us see how Volvox undergoes sexual reproduction. In Volvox colony, certain cells located at the posterior part of the colony develop to antheridia. And the cells which are destined to form antheridia, it withdraws its flagella, and you can see here the cell. It gets rounded off, it withdraws its flagella, its protoplasm rounds off to form a spherical body, it enlarges in size also. See the size, it, when compared to the other cells, it enlarges in size. And what happens is the protoplast of, we call that cell gonidia. So the protoplast of gonidia, it undergoes division in longitudinal plane. And it divides to form a number of protoplast. The number may range from 16 to more than 500 in number, and the number is different in different species of Volvox. And the cells and the number of protoplast which are formed after division, they get arranged into a plakia as found in asexual reproduction. And so they arrange into plakia and then form a sphere-like structure. See, they arrange first like a plakia and then form a sphere-like structure. The whole structure gets surrounded by a membrane, which will be two-layered membrane, and it will be derived from the original cell wall also. So this gets rounds off. It gets surrounded by a layer, cell layer, that will be two layered and will be derived from the original parent cell wall. The protoplast undergoes inversion like we found in asexual reproduction, and later it produces, each of the protoplast, they produce cell wall and flagellas comes out. See here, in up to this stage, until they form a sphere, they are just pieces of protoplast, and after that, attaining maturity, each of these protoplast gather individual cell walls which are derived from the original cells, and they transform to individual cells, and they also gather flagella. And this happens after undergoing inversion. So each of these cells, they have contractile vacuole, nucleus, mitochondria, and all other cell organelles are present there. And these are the male gametes now, or we can call them as spermatocytes. They are arranged in the form of a bowl shaped plate in some cases or in some species, while in some others they may be arranged as a hollow sphere. And the sphere may have an opening to the outside, this opening, see, that is called as phialopore. This was the same term we met during asexual reproduction also. As maturation begins, the plate or sphere of the spermatozoids may undergo inversion, but as in the asexual reproduction, and as a result, the anterior end of the anthrozoids, they may get directed outwards. The same process as we learnt in asexual reproduction. And after release, the released anthrozoids, they actively swim about in water, and they reach to the proximity of a mature egg. And as soon as they encounter an egg, they go on for fertilization. So that is all about anthrozoids or the spermatozoids. Now coming to the development of oospores. The formation of oospore or the female gamete, here also a gonadal cell is formed, which is pushed to the inside of the colony. See, a cell which transforms to a gonadia, it gets pushed towards the inside of the colony. and then it receives plenty of reserve food material from the neighboring somatic cell through the cytoplasmic connections, and they also enlarge in size. They enlarge in size, and it loses its flagella same way happening during the male gamete formation. They lose their flagella and eyespot and gets its chloroplast and nucleus enlarged. And the complete protoplast of the oogonium now transforms to a female gamete, or we call it as egg or oosphere. The egg has a receptive spore which receives the male gamete. So this is a mature egg. It first, one of the cell from the colony, it gets signal and we call it as gonidia. It is pushed towards the inside, it enlarges in size, its nucleus, chloroplast all enlarges, it withdraws its flagella and it becomes an active egg. This egg has a receptive spore, and this receptive spore is the spore which receives the anthrozoids. As soon as an anthrozoid gets into this, gets in through this phialopore, they encounters the egg, fertilization happen, and as a result, zygote is formed. Now regarding the formation of zygospora, the fertilization, as you can see, it happens in the inside of the colony. And here what happens, an actively swimming anthrozoids come in contact with a stationary egg. Egg is stationary, but anthrozoid is the one which is motile. It swims and comes to the egg, and it fuses to form a diploid zygote. And some species of Volvox are monoecious species, while some others are dioecious species. In monoecious species, as a rule, we know there it will be have cross fertilization is the rule in monoecious species, whereas in dioecious species both cross fertilization and self fertilization can be possible. And as soon as the fertilization is over, the zygote, it will secrete a wall. A thick wall will be secreted, which will be three layered and smooth or spiny in nature. Here you can see it is spiny. So a wall is secreted which is three layered. It may be smooth or spiny, and it becomes a oospore or zygospores. The three layers of the zygospore are, from outside it is exospore, middle mesospore and inner endospore. And this zygospore is, as it is this much thick walled body, it will be resistant. So it will be resting body also to tide over the unfavorable conditions. And during this period it synthesizes sufficient amount of hematochrome and turns orange red in color. So the zygospore, it will get orange red color due to the presence of hematochrome. And when this zygospore is released, it is released free, or it is released to the outside by the death and disintegration of this parent colony. See, it is inside the parent colony now. So when the parent colony becomes disintegrated, then only the zygospore will be get free. And after the arrival of a favorable condition, this zygospore, this resting body called zygospore, it undergoes germination. Then during the germination, what happens? The nucleus divides meiotically and forms, the zygospore is now diploid. It undergoes meiotic division and forms haploid nuclei. And in some cases, only one of the four meiotic nuclei or one of the four haploid nuclei will survive. It depends upon the species. The exospore and the mesospore of the spore wall gelatinizes or dissolves, and the endospore protrudes out during the germination process. And through this protrusion, the protoplast containing the haploid nuclei, it moves into this vesicle and develops a biflagellate meiospore. This meiospore rarely escapes from the vesicle. It undergoes repeated mitotic division and forms a hollow sphere. This sphere undergoes inversion and develops to a new colony. So that is about the germination of zygospore. So it is a simple process. We have gone through the formation of male gametes and female gametes. After these male and female gametes are formed, they go for fertilization, and after fertilization a diploid zygote is formed. This diploid zygote, it will secrete a three-layered wall which may be smooth or spiny around it, and these three-layered wall are, the three layers are exospore, mesospore and endospore. And then what happens, this zygospore, it will attain a orange-red color as it synthesizes great amount of hematochrome. And after that, what happens when the advent of favorable conditions occur, this zygospore, they undergo germination. And during the germination, what happens? During germination, the diploid nucleus, it undergoes meiotic division and forms four haploid nuclei. Of these four haploid nuclei, only one may survive. And this how many number of nuclei will survive, that depends upon the species involved. And during germination, the exospore and mesospore of the spore wall, it dissolves, and the endospore protrudes out as a small vesicle. And the protoplast containing the haploid functional nuclei, it moves to the vesicle, and eventually it develops to a biflagellate meiospore. And this meiospore, it undergoes meiotic division and forms number of cells and becomes holosphere-like, and it undergoes inversion to form a new colony. So that is all about sexual reproduction in wall box.